Schools in Ho Chi Minh City to reopen from May 4th. Entertainment facilities remain closed. If the FTA to be submitted to the National Assembly for approval. Big technology groups shifting manufacturers to Vietnam. Hello, it's good to have you back here on FBNC News. I'm Trinh Lê. Now, the COVID-19 infection curve in Vietnam has been flattened for quite some time, as no new patients were found in more than 1 week. However, there are 9 recovered patients who reinfected so far, which complicates the situation going forward. So up to now, Vietnam has 270 cases of COVID-19, of which 221 cases have been cured and 49 cases are still being treated. Schools across Ho Chi Minh City will welcome students back starting from May 4th after a 3.5-month break, while beauty salons, spas and entertainment facilities will remain closed.
According to the latest decision of Ho Chi Minh City People's Committee, over 87,000 ninth graders who are about to take their high school entrance exams and over 63,000 12th graders who will be taking their high school graduation exams will go back to school on the 4th of May and start normal classes the next day. Students from the 4th to 8th grade and 10th and 11th graders will start classes from the 11th of May. Those from the 1st to 3rd grades will start classes on the 12th of May. Kindergarten classes will reopen between the 18th of May and the 1st of June. At the same time, the city asked for the continued suspension of beauty spas and entertainment facilities such as cinemas, theaters, bars, karaoke bars and beer clubs. All religious activities, sports competitions and meetings with more than 30 people are also not allowed until further notice.
The Ho Chi Minh City Power Corporation on April 28th said it has resumed a number of electricity projects after the southern city ceased social distancing measures.
Many projects have been completed ahead of schedule to welcome the 45th anniversary of Liberation of the South and the National Reunification Day. According to the group management, EVN Ho Chi Minh City has been working to enhance the power supply to meet the city's development requirements. However, due to the COVID-19 outbreak, it had to delay some projects. However, some key projects still have been carried out during the social distancing, such as the 220 kV Cát Lai Tân Cảng and 110 kV Bình Tân Cầu Bông power lines, and the 110 kV Phước Long station. The company is also upgrading other transmission lines in the city.
The National Assembly Standing Committee has agreed that the EU-Vietnam Free Trade Agreement and the EU-Vietnam Investment Protection Agreement will be submitted to the upcoming National Assembly session for approval.
The proposal was discussed by the National Assembly Standing Committee on April 28th before the committee wrapped up its 44th session. The National Assembly Standing Committee expressed the need to approve the assessment on the two agreements. However, Vice National Assembly Chairwoman Tổng Thị Phóng requested more evaluation be made about the deal's impacts after the COVID-19 pandemic, especially after the UK left the EU, as well as the new challenges after the two deals take effect, along with opportunities they may bring. The National Assembly Standing Committee asked the government and relevant agencies to continue review laws related to the two agreements for adjustment so as to ensure the consistency of the legal system and the observance of the Constitution.
Foreign direct investment disbursement in the central city of Da Nang was over $76 million since the start of 2020, a year-on-year surge of 92% despite the COVID-19 pandemic.
Da Nang's total development investment was estimated at over 7 trillion Vietnam dongs in the first quarter, down 8% compared to the same period last year. The FDI sector has seen a rise in investment attraction thanks to the implementation of several big projects, notably the Sunshine Aerospace Components Manufacturing Facility launched by the Universal Alloy Corporation Vietnam. To date, the city has welcomed 844 FDI projects totaling $3.47 billion. Meanwhile, Da Nang has attracted four state-owned projects with a combined capital of over 8.61 trillion Vietnam dongs since the start of the year, bringing the total to 335 projects and 112.6 trillion Vietnam dongs in investment.
Vietnam has remained an attractive destination for Thai enterprises to expand their business despite the COVID-19 pandemic spreading across the region.
Thailand's Delta Electronics PCL, a global producer of power and thermal management products and solutions, earlier this month announced it will establish a new subsidiary in Vietnam in the second or third quarter this year. The subsidiary will be incorporated in Vietnam with a charter capital of $500,000, the company said, and will be involved in trade and solutions using Delta's electronics products to benefit stakeholders and support local customers. Jackie Jang, president of Delta Electronics, said the pandemic has not forced his company to change its expansion plans in Southeast Asia. "We expect Vietnam to play a key role in driving regional development, and Delta is ready to take an active role in the country's growth story," he said. The acquisition is a crucial step in the company's plan to expand its business and improve its financial performance in the long term, said President and CEO Chosum Lochaya. "The economy will recover and demand for electricity will continue to rise," he added. So the company decided to make these deals. The Nikkei Asian Review reported this month that the Siam Cement Group of Thailand will acquire Vietnamese packaging manufacturer Binhua Packaging Joint Stock Company through a joint venture with leading Japanese cardboard producer Rengo. Siam Cement said it was attracted by the growth potential of online shopping, as more and more Southeast Asian consumers choose to shop online to limit trips to crowded places as part of preventive measures against the spread of COVID-19. The deal is estimated to be worth some 635 billion Thai baht, equivalent to $19.2 million. Thailand is currently Vietnam's ninth largest investor, with 549 projects worth more than $10 billion. Investors from the country injected $43.64 million into Vietnam in the first quarter of this year.
The movement of large corporations to shift production out of China has been underway since the U.S.-China trade intensified. Now the COVID-19 pandemic is continuing to accelerate that process, and Vietnam is being the preferred choice of many large technology companies.
Representative of Petragon, an iPhone assembler, said that the company hopes to start manufacturing in Vietnam in 2021. Inventec, the main assembly partner of AirPod products, also said it is preparing to build a new facility in Vietnam. Apple's supply chain in China in February was paralyzed, causing the wave of production moving out of China to accelerate, especially small-scale manufacturers. COVID-19 is considered a new catalyst pushing the production shift faster after being driven by trade tensions between the US and China last year. Therefore, Southeast Asia in general and Vietnam in particular will be more attractive to businesses in the future. Data from the U.S. Census Bureau shows that the volume of goods imported from Vietnam in 2019 increased by 35.6% over the same period of 2018, in contrast to a decrease of 16.2% in the volume of goods imported from China.
The Hanoi F1 Grand Prix may take place late this year, as Formula One CEO Chase Carey recently announced that the 2020 season is expected to start soon.
In a statement of the latest developments of the 2020 F1 calendar, CEO Chase Carey said that he is very optimistic about starting the season in Europe through July, August and early September, with the first race taking place in Austria from 3rd to 5th of July. September, October and November would see racing in Europe, Asia, Americas, so that the season might finish in December. Based on the announcement, the stage in Hanoi could take place in November. To date, 10 out of 22 races have been delayed due to the COVID-19 pandemic, including the Vietnam debut that was set to take place in Hanoi from 3rd to 4th of April.
That has been FBNC News for today. Thank you for watching. We look forward to seeing you next time. Goodbye.